What's up, Elevate Salawag? This is Kuya Rob, and I bring greetings from Elevate Anonas. I hope you and your families are safe and healthy as we go through this global pandemic called coronavirus. Now, talking about COVID-19, maybe some of you are feeling fear because of the growing number of cases in our country. For some, maybe you're worried about the future because your parents got laid off from work and you don't know where you would get your provision for your daily needs. For some, maybe you're anxious because supposed to be the lockdown period is over, but it was extended. So fears, worries, anxiety because of the current situation. But let me encourage you, the disciples of Jesus experienced the same thing. In fact, in Luke chapter 8, we find Jesus telling his disciples, let's go over to the other side. And as they were journeying and sailing, a furious storm came in. The disciples were afraid. They thought they're going to die. So they woke Jesus up, telling him, Master, Master, we're going to drown. Then Jesus got up, rebuked the winds and the waves, and everything was calm. After performing the miracle, Jesus asked the disciples this question. And I believe this is also the question of God to us as we go through this global pandemic. Where is your faith? Where is your faith? You know, two things that Jesus calmed during this time is, number one, the storm that was happening outside, the winds and the waves, and the storm that was happening inside the hearts of the disciples, the lack of faith and unbelief. The disciples experienced testings. And two things about testings that I want to share to you. Number one, testings make us depend on God. Now, looking at the story, the disciples had no choice but to depend on Jesus for the miracle to happen, for Jesus to save them. Same goes with us when we have challenges and testings in life, it makes us realize that we need God. I remember the first time I went to the gym, hindi ko kayang magbuhat ng mabibigat. I need someone to help me. I need a spotter for me to finish my exercise and repetitions. The same goes with life. When we experience the weight of life, pag bigat na bigat ka na, we need to go to God and we need to depend on Him. The second thing about testings I want to share to you, testings bring blessings. You know, the storm was there for the disciples to realize who Jesus really was. Prior to this event, they know that Jesus was a leader, was a teacher, was a miracle worker. But just calming the seas and the storm, it shows that He is God and that He is powerful and they can depend on Him. The same goes with us. You know, pag may mga challenges tayo, it brings blessings. I remember when the COVID lockdown was still starting, I was doing my quiet time. I was asking the Lord. I was telling Him, Lord, why did you allow coronavirus to happen? And while I was doing my meditation, while I was doing my journaling, eventually He spoke to me and I heard this audible voice. And He told me the reason He allowed those things to happen is for me to realize that everything I need can be found at home. Number one, I see my Bible and I realize that my priority is my relationship with God. When sometimes we are outside, we tend to forget our quiet times. We tend to forget God because of the busyness of life. But number one, I realize ko, importante yung relationship ko kay God. Second thing is I see my wife, my beautiful, gorgeous, godly wife. And nakikita ko that family is important. And sometimes when we have the freedom to go outside, our families are set aside. Our families are neglected. And the more na we experience this lockdown, the more we are forced in a good way to spend time with them and to get to know them intimately. And lastly, I see my friends online. I see their rants, their complaints, and I realize that their soul matters, that I need to share the gospel to them, and I need to share the hope that I have in Christ. If hindi ko na-experience yung lockdown, then I wouldn't realize what really matters in life, because testings bring blessings. You know, two things that we have learned today. Number one, testings make us depend on God. And testings bring blessings. I hope and I pray as we go through this lockdown period that we will fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. there may be winds and waves and doubts and fears and worries and unbelief. But let's put our trust in Jesus, because what He started in our life, He will surely complete it. Have faith in Jesus. Embrace testings.